Hello, beautiful souls. Welcome back to this page, Divine Tea with Luna. I've been on a sabbatical and I am back. Why I was on a sabbatical and what all happened, I would be posting a life update video. But I was really called to do a very small reading today. And the options are, number one, Tiger's Eye, Carnelian and Rose Quartz, okay, in that order. So those are the options, but let us talk about what is the topic for today's reading. So today's reading is just a mini reading about anything that you want to ask for. So if you're watching this on Instagram, please ask any question that you want to and go ahead and choose between Tiger's Eye, Carnelian or Rose Quartz. If you're called, you can also choose two of them. That's up to you. But we're gonna start off with people who chose Tiger's Eye, okay? Dear Spirit, what do the people who chose this pile, the Tiger's Eye, need to know? Okay. The Devil. The first card that comes out is Devil. So, and that's the back of the deck energy. I haven't even pulled cards yet. So, I do feel that the people who chose Tiger's Eye are going through temptations, are going through addictions, and they want to break free. Some of you want to break free, not all of you. Some of you have actually given into certain addictions, and it can be anything, starting from food, drugs, alcohol, even people trying to escape every time. That is an issue, or that is itself an addiction. If you don't want to spend time by yourself, if you don't feel like spending time with yourself, or you're just trying to fill the void inside by other things, that's your overall energy right now. The first card is Three of Pentacles reversed. So you are opposed to collaborations. You're opposed to building things with others. I do immediately sense that there's something going on with trust issues. You don't trust people enough. Okay. And the next is Two of Cups. So I think this is the energy that you need to bring in. Two of Cups is okay. In this card, you can see it's a very beautiful card of two people together. But Two of Cups need not be a romantic relationship all the time. It can also mean partnerships coming together to do something. And the next card you've gotten is Strength reversed. So yes, you don't want to step into your own power right now, and there are certain things that are going on within yourself. So I'm just going to show you the cards, right? The first one, opposition to working with others, but Spirit is asking you to trust others and find a way out. Yeah, and Strength reversed is that you're giving into this entire addiction, this entire energy of wanting to be in chains. You feel that you're not strong enough, or you don't want to put in the work. And that can be for a multiple reasons, right? So we can't really be sure about it. And because many of you would be tuning into this video, yeah, and if I'm not wrong, Tiger's Eye, I'm just going off the animal totem in that sense. Tiger's Eye is suddenly I feel that you have to reclaim your power. Somewhere you have given away your power, and that's what you need to do. Okay, so let's see if you have any prompts coming out from the Witchlings deck. Confidence. Okay, so yes, you are lacking confidence at the moment, but you can banish things. You can banish the negative energies. You can find a way out. You have the power to banish negative energies and unwanted problems. And this sits under the Three of Pentacles reversed. The next card, which is sitting on the Two of Cups, is Euphoria. Damn. Euphoria is a cosmic connection to the magic within and around you. So before you can even think about collaborating with other people, you need to find out why you're feeling this way, why you're wary of trusting someone else. And I have to tell you this from personal experience. The moment we are scared of trusting someone else, we are scared of ourselves. In the sense, you can want to do a lot of things, right? What I mean is, till you don't have a good connection with yourself and the universe, if you don't trust yourself, if you're scared that you're always going to go down the wrong path or bad things happening to you, that is an indication that you don't trust that good things are going to happen. And we are our belief systems, because our belief systems give rise to our state of being, so on and so forth. So yes, before you can even want to have a collaboration work-wise, many things, you need to step back and claim your power. And under this strength reversed card, we have abundance. Harmonize your thinking to what exactly you want to attract, and the universe will desire, the universe will deliver. Yes. So you see, these cards are sitting right under these cards. And yes, pile number one, you have the power. You are just not seeing that you have it. Okay, now we're gonna move on to those who chose carnelian. This is a sacral chakra crystal which is used. And if you've chosen this crystal, it might mean that you need to find more connection and balance with your body, with your sexuality, in the way you express love. Ooh, am I getting any other messages? There's this need for you to be peaceful. You're not peaceful within right now, and you're really craving that. And I can feel that it's there, but you're not seeing it. In the sense, it depends upon your actions and it's attainable, but yeah, there's something that you're not seeing. It's right around the corner, okay? Okay. So we have the King of Swords reversed. King of Swords reversed. Then the first card we have, it's Page of Swords reversed. So there's a suppression of truth going on somewhere. There's confusion. Things are blurry. You don't know exactly how things are going to go forward. And there can be an authoritative figure doing this to you, or you can be the authoritative figure in somebody's life doing it to someone else. I strongly feel there are issues. You're going through certain issues of power. And the next card is King of Wands upright. Again, somebody who is again in an authoritative place, and this king is all about determination, following through, and planning. And then we have the Death card. I do feel that you're stuck somewhere, you're stuck in between. There's something going on, okay? And how do I say it? There's a tussle going on. It can be within two authoritative figures. One is trying to screw you over, the other is not. You can be either of them, or you can be in the middle of them in their fight. But whatever is going on between these two authoritative figures, there's something happening. It's there's this lack of clarity upon how you want to do things. And the last card that we got was death. So expect deep transformations and transmutations, because this tussle that you're in is bringing a lot of change. It's gonna literally kill you and make you make you rise from it again. Yeah. I just want to find another clarifier as to what spirit, what is this confusion about? Like, what is this confusion about? Why is the Page of Swords in reverse? Okay, this card is sticking out. It's Queen of Wands reversed. So, is there something like, what's going on? Why are there so many people in this pile? And why are all of them affecting you so much? Okay, whoever this person is, the Queen of Wands, she has given into her shadow aspects a little too much. She's refusing to, she's not refusing, but she's dealing with her shadow self a little too much. And for that reason, she's not coming out. She's not being the social butterfly, the queen who knows it, who has her shadow aspects and her light aspects in balance. It feels a little disbalanced. Yeah, so a woman or a feminine energy is responsible for this confusion. So yeah, just I hope. Let's see what other if there are any other, like, any other things that can help you deal with this confusion. Let's see. Okay. Meditation will clear your mind, and because we always have the answers we are seeking. There's nothing that, again, confidence. The confusion, the blurriness can actually affect your confidence. So yeah, that is something that you need to work. Self-confidence opens you to the energy required to carry you through each day at your best. Energy. Yeah. With limitless energy, you'll achieve more than you've ever imagined. So, and this sits right under King of Wands. So yes, this is very, this is going in sync. So somehow I'm getting the feeling that it is you who are the King of Wands, but let's see. And then last month is strength under death. So yes, whenever we are going through crazy transformations, it's of utmost importance that we do actually stand in our strength and see through this change, dying of things that we would not have wanted to see otherwise. Yeah, that's what I see for you. Pile number two. I do feel there's a heavy energy with pile two though. Okay. That's it for you, pile two. I'm going to move on to the people who chose the rose quartz. Okay. Spirit, what messages do we have for the people who chose rose quartz? If you've chosen rose quartz, for sure you need more self-love, and nine of pentacles is reversed, so dealing with issues of material wealth. Seven of cups, you are also having a lot of options right now. you have a lot of options in regards to maybe how you will be feeling materially fulfilled. You might want to take, you might just have a lot of things you want to do, but you don't know which one would be the correct one. Also, there is some, there's a block monetarily, and let's see what else spirit. Oh, this one, and the Hierophant, which is reversed, so control issues. You're confused because of that. You're confused because things are not falling into your, because the things are not falling into patterns anymore, the patterns that you were used to, and it's changing. Let me hear what messages I'm getting. Okay. You should not be following traditions. You should not be following traditions. And if you are in this place where you're confused as to, okay, there are so many things that I can do, what should be the best thing that I should be doing? I would suggest go for the road less taken. Go for the, like, pave your own path, okay? And I'm sure something's gonna come out of it. And you're being asked to take a risk. It's always a risk doing something non-traditional. So yeah, and if possible, see, it's also, Seven of Cups is also a card of imagination. So even though you have a lot of options, can you find out a way where you can bring together some of the options together? I know you can't bring all of them together. Or maybe you can. I don't know. Creativity works in different ways. And you have... Okay, your card fell. Okay. So the card we got is enthusiasm. Yeah. Life is always brighter when you wake up each day with a spirit of enthusiasm. So as I was saying that, you know, you need to let this creative energy flow through you right now and see if you can be materially fulfilled with that, if you can find stability doing something like that, okay? And it sits under Nine of Pentacles, okay? Okay. The next one is... You need to cleanse your energy, and transformations are on the horizon. I really feel you need to give into this creativity. You need to give into this creative energy. Self-transformation is the evolving process of life that brings higher consciousness. So yeah, there is a reason why you've been called to, why you have been given so many options, or suddenly you know that, okay, these are the things that I can do. So which way should I go? It's very obvious to be confused about it. As we know, the more number of options we have, the more confused we get. Okay. And under the Hierophant, we've gotten Serenity. The spirit of serenity brings a calmness to the connectivity of all that it is. So in tarot, we know Hierophant is the Pope. He is the traditional head of the religion. He's the one people go to. But it's in reverse. And I highly feel that your path is not down that traditional path. Even though you might have till date been something or someone who's really good at in your field, but suddenly you don't need to be that anymore. The universe is asking you that you have the permission to change these things about yourself, and it is going to change via something financial. So yes, and I'll ask you to be a little more sympathetic and empathetic to yourself, because it's crazy how much and how many times we can feel that, or we are not empathetic to ourselves. So, yeah, have a little bit of self-love. Maybe that's going to help you find out the answer. But I genuinely feel you have to master your feminine energy. In this world, everything is about masculine, 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 that we forget that without the feminine aspect, we'll never become whole. So give into that creativity, and I'm sure you'll find out something, okay? That's it for today. See you again.